All right, it's a brilliant afternoon. We're in Nigeria, so it's 1 a.m. in Nigeria. And then, of course, we are very much good to go on today's power-packed masterclass. Our masterclass has always been a very exciting moment for everyone because we get to bring in experts in the industry to tell us specifically from their area of expertise what we need to give an edge to what we are currently doing. Today, again, we have another big fish in the house, somebody that's well known in the industry, especially around poultry and livestock farming. Is almost synonymous to a household name in terms of sales and marketing of products. Dr. Joseph Dejifolutile. Right, you know, sometimes you get to miss his name and call him for time, but you know, he has corrected us quite a handful of time. That is not, you know, the last time I called him, he said, "Are you not Yoruba?" Hey, Yoruba is an ethnic division in Nigeria, so his the right pronunciation for his name is Dr. Joseph Dejifolutile. Dr. Dejifolutile has been, as I said initially, in the marketing front for quite maybe around over getting close to 40 years now. So you can imagine the huge experience. He worked in the then Pfizer as the market research manager, moved on to being a product manager, then of course now became like their marketing manager. Ever since, Dr. Dejifolutile has trained quite a lot of sales rep, consulted for a lot of companies, and then has earned himself the marketing genius in the livestock industry. I'm going to be bringing Dr. Dejifolutile up shortly. Hey, Doc. Good day, sir.
Yeah, I'm doing fine.
Good, very well. Good to have you on the show this afternoon. And then good to have you and have your experience on board. All right, so let's start. So let's just give us a brief background and why you are crafting a niche for yourself in the marketing angle in the livestock industry. I know you do quite a handful of things, but why sales? Why marketing? Why do we all come to you when it turns to when we have our marketing challenge in the livestock industry? Why do you have to focus on that? Go ahead, sir.
Great. You know, the everything about business is marketing. Everything about business. If you don't get the marketing aspect of any business, you're not a business person. And I've seen that the missing link, you know, in the farming industry is marketing. And why? Because you thought that the farmers are not getting much out of what they do because they've neglected marketing a lot. And because the marketing says is inside marketing. Marketing is the business. If you don't get the marketing right, you are not getting the business right. Anything you are doing,
okay, I guess you have some network issues.
You cannot benefit much out of life. And because marketing is where the business is. And what is marketing? Marketing is how to make a business attractive to customers, which makes selling unnecessary. You know, how do I make my business attractive to customers that makes selling unnecessary? That I just sell, you know, and that's why, you know, if you look at some organization where I was trained, you know, I was trained in a way that we have sales department, we have marketing department. You know, today you see a lot of people combining it and say sales marketing manager. There's nothing like sales marketing manager. Sales manager, marketing manager. Because where the salesman stop is where the marketing man starts. When you go, when you tell the salesman to go and sell something, all the salesman knows is that, oh, this product is for this price. Let me go and push it. Now, when it gets to a point where you cannot sell anymore, it comes back They asked him and said, "Oh, why can't you say?" He said, "Because our price is too high." Hmm. He said, "Because customers are not buying." Hmm. So the salesman doesn't know what to do. So the marketing man will have to go to the table and think it out. Hmm. How can I make selling unnecessary? Hmm. How can I create a way that when people go out to sell, they find it easy to sell to customers? Hmm. So the marketing team, they are the one that will now declare strategies, you know, strategies and tactics that the salesman will go and now implement and now find it easy to sell to customers. Mm.
Let me quickly cut you short. I know you have a lot to deliver, and we have almost 45 minutes to get that delivered. But I want you to, you made mention of something that really struck a chord in me, right? You said farmers are not getting that much because they've not gotten this part right. You know, when we're growing up, when you call yourself a farmer, it's another word for calling yourself poor, right? So we get people to now want to reorientate us, telling us that farming is a business, farming, it's a good business, right? But almost all farmers, in quote, I see some differences. Now, especially some of us who are now marketing and wearing suit, or who are farmers are not wearing suit. But when you mention the word farmer, you are invariably calling the person a poor person, right? And you now mention now very significantly that the reason why they are not getting much is because they are not good marketers, or they are not doing enough marketing, right? Why do you think this problem exists?
Well, the problem is because of ignorance. Mm. It's ignorance, you know. And if you look at the farming business, anything you are doing as a business, you have the business, and the end of every business is the customer. Mm. Is the customer, and the customer, you know, even though we have chain, but the ultimate customer is the end user of your product. Mm. That's the ultimate customer. And if you don't see it that way, and you just feel that, oh, I want to be a farmer, and you think farming is about production, if I can just produce, if I can just produce, if I can not produce. So you have so many people who focus so much on production, and then they go into farming, and then maybe the guy, let's give an example. Someone is starting a poultry farm, okay? Maybe by the time he starts, maybe he has about 200 beds, and then they lay eggs. And he's selling 3 crates, and people are coming to ask him, please, I want to buy egg. I want to buy. Then because of that, he now step up and I begin to have 500 beds. Then people are still coming to him. I want to buy egg. Want to buy. Then because of that, he now moves to 1,000 beds. You know, as from 1,000 beds, the craze of egg began to increase. The customers are not coming as at that. So maybe he used to get customers to come and buy. Maybe 20 crates. Now they come to buy 20 crates, there are still 50 crates on the ground, not sold. They now begin to say, they are thought this business is there now. So we now begin to get worried, you know. And he doesn't know that farming is not just about production. Farming is not about production. I keep telling farmers, I may not even know how a chicken look like. And I can be making money in poultry business than the actual farmer who is doing the farming.
You need to say that again, right? Because you know that's very striking. You may not even know a lot about the poultry production.
I may not even know how a chicken look like. But if I know where the eggs end up, I will make more money than the farmer. You know, if I know where the eggs end up in, and I can know where I can get the eggs to. And if one does not know, he can just produce. I know how to sell the eggs to the people that will eat the egg. I will make more money than the farmer.
But let me cut you short, right? I hope farmers are listening to this. Because this is what makes the difference. The biggest difference between whether you will be a struggling farmer or you will be a farmer that shines brighter. And then, you know, farmers don't smile. You see their hands hard, you see their clothes tattered, you see them complain, and yet they are at the heart of the production. but at the bottom end of the money.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
Dr. Deji Folutile is now saying is that you can be at the heart of the production and also be smiling to the bank. And what you need is marketing 101. Doctor, how do we begin even to get it right? Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, the way to get it right is if you are doing any business, including farming, you have to start with market, not with product.
Do you mind saying that again?
Yeah, if you are doing any business, whether you are doing farming or any business, you have to start with the market, not the product.
Please, let me cut you short. You just hold your breath. You're dishing out too strong a word in too short a time, right? Farmers listening, did you hear that?
Yeah.
He said, when you want to start, because again, I think the orientation is permit me to use the word warp, right? Because when a farmer wants to start, all he knows is, I need to get my seed stock, I need to get workers, I need to get money, and then I need to ensure that the beds come out well. But here is the expert in marketing saying that when you want to start, it's not to rent a farm or build your pen. It's to start with the basic question. Where is the money going to come from? Where's the market? Am I getting you correctly, Dr. Deji Folutile?
Yeah, yes.
Please go ahead.
Yes. Okay, you want to start with the market. Assuming I want to be a poultry farmer, I want to start a poultry farmer, and I want to say I want to raise broilers. So I would divide my. I used to tell farmers this simple formula. I call it 60-30-10. 60M, 30M, and 10M. The 60M is that 60% of your time in business should be devoted to marketing. Yeah. You know? 60% of your time, at any point in time, even if your business is 100 years old, 60, people, no, no, doctor, look at it yourself. The great marketers in the world today, the internet, I mean, the Glow, the MTN, the Coca-Cola, most of their time is devoted to marketing. You know, so 60% of your time should be on marketing. Then I call it 60M, 30M, 10M. Now, the 60M is 60% on marketing. The 30M, 30% on making the product. And the 10M, 10% on management. So 60M, 30M, 10M. You do business like that, you can't fail. You can't but make money. Because once you have the market, that is where the money is. That is where the money is. That is where the money is.
Let me recap. Let me recap.
Okay.
I'm enjoying this, and I wish more farmers will watch this episode. Did you hear what Dr. Deji Folutile said? 60% of your time should be devoted to marketing. Another 30 on making the product, and then 10% to managing. Go ahead, doctor. Because I need to absorb this.
So if you do that, now look at it now. If you look at the industry, I've been in the industry, the farming industry, for over 35 years. And I can tell you that when you look at the activities in the farming industry, it's more production-oriented than marketing-oriented. It's more production. If you see companies giving seminars to farmers, every seminar is on production. Production. How do you produce a production? How do you do this? How do you do that? So you have so many farmers who know how to produce, but they don't know how to sell the products. Now you see some middlemen, they have built empires. They have built empire because they know where the products end up to. So they hold the farmer to ransom. And now the farmers are dealing with live products. You are dealing with eggs, you are dealing with fish, you are dealing with things that can perish, like really the tomatoes, you are dealing with maize. So when the farmers are desperate to sell, the middlemen, they know where the product will end up. So they hold the farmer at the ransom. Sell your product or the product gets spoiled. So you don't see, so otherwise it shouldn't be like that. Even as farmers, individually and collectively, every effort should be geared towards marketing. And marketing is simply this: how do we make these products attractive, you know, to end users? How do we get access to end users? How do we even cut off middlemen? How do we create a demand for the product that we sell? So that, now let me give you an example, Doug. Do you know that an average man will rather, if he has 1,000 naira to spend, he rather use that 1,000 naira to buy beer, you know, maybe buy soft drink, than spending any of it on buying eggs. Meanwhile, between me and you, you know, egg is more nutritious than drinking beer. So it's not as if people don't have money to spend. If you go to, like, in our country,
that's
country,
correct.
If you go to Lagos, the computer village, where they sell electronics, where they sell all these cell phones, you see a typical person coming there to buy cell phones of about 100,000 naira. You know, and we buy it, and after about 4 weeks again, say, I want to, the latest has come out, I'll go and buy another one. And you tell this person to buy a crate of egg for 2,000 naira, he doesn't want to buy. Why? Because the farmers have not done their work in enhancing the value of egg to humanity.
Wow.
I don't know what I'm getting my
So
we're talking about marketing in terms of even the farmers. The farmers are not doing good work in projecting the benefit of their product to the populace. Like when your product is very known, your product is known. Oh, I know if I eat egg, it's good for my health. I know if I eat broilers, I know it's good for me. I know if I eat chicken that is fresh, made in Nigeria, it's good for me. And they can budget money to buy those products, which you can produce to sell to them. But now, your effort is basically focused on staying down, producing day and night. Producing day and night. All your energy is spent on production. Now, after you have produced, now, can you eat the product yourself? No. You have to get to the farmer, to the consumers. Now, the consumers are here. Your product is not a preference to them to buy. Yeah, your product is subjective to the people that are marketing product. They rather buy a Coca-Cola than buy an egg. They rather buy beer than buy chicken. So when you have people that think that the business is not expanding, whereas if the farmers are doing a lot of work on marketing, projecting the food, projecting eggs, projecting broilers, projecting chicken, projecting meat, projecting fish, you know, the value to humankind in terms of protein, in terms of nutrition, there will be a high demand. Awareness. Oh, I need to have egg in the house. I need to have chicken in the house. I need to have. So when there is a lot of demand for those, then you now produce. You cannot be, see, when too much demand is fetching too few supply, then you have business. As it is now, it is not a seller's market. It is a buyer's market. And when you have a buyer's market in any business, you are at a loss. So, but if you project what you are doing very well, and people know the value of egg, they know the value of chicken, the value of eating fresh chicken, the value of eating, having egg in the house at all times, then you have a seller's market. Because people are running after egg. I need to have egg. Even if I don't I don't change my phone in 2 years, my family should be having fresh egg to eat in the house because it's protein, it's, you know, it's good for my health. But that is not the case today. And that is why you see that when I joined my company, when I was working about 35 years ago, you know, I knew how much they were selling Coca-Cola. Maybe about 25 kobo. You know, and I know how much they were selling egg. Now, they have multiplied the prices of Coca-Cola more than 500 times, whereas the egg cannot be multiplied. So it means that anywhere you go, you see, you know, Coca-Cola, they sponsoring football, sponsoring game. Why? Because they keep bombarding you with it, and then they enhance the product in your sight, and there is demand for it. The farmers are not doing that. Both as a body, and as individuals. So you see a typical farmer is putting all his energy to produce this product, but he's putting less energy to promote the product. And so that's why a middleman will always take the money. I know a woman, the woman is late now. The woman does not know the farm. She doesn't need the farmer. She's just a farmer. But she knows where to sell chicken to. Chicken. So when the farmers are in trouble, they always call her. Illiterate. They always call her, Mama, we cannot sell our chicken. He said, bring them. Bring them. And when everybody, when farmer A brings our chicken, farmer B bring our chicken, farmer C bring our chicken, then she has all the chicken. She can say, I can't buy more than so price. Well, okay, Mama, you can take it. You can take it because Mama knows where the chicken will end up. The farmer does not know where the chicken will end up. So, like me now, the business I do, I'm more concerned about the end users than anything. Once I have the end users, I have the business. Once I have the end users, I have the business. Let me give an example. When I was trying to produce a magazine for the industry, for the farming industry, you know, about 17 years ago, I went to the association, farmer association. I said, I have this project I want to do to enhance farmers. Let's do it together. Let's produce a magazine for farmers together. And they were just doing me like, okay. And I told myself, I said, in about 2 or 3 years or 4 years, farmers will come to me to buy data of farmers. So all I do is just, any farmer, no matter who you are, you're my friend. Because I know that is where I can hold the advertisers who want to get the farmers.
Exactly.
If I have the farmers in my pocket,
exactly,
then I have the advertiser in my pocket.
Exactly. Exactly.
So that is how you have to look at it, that the farmers should be bothered about who are eating my products. Who are eating my products? Who are eating my product? I need to get those who are eating my product. I need to know many of them. I need to have their data. I need to educate them. I need to do meetings for them. I need to add value to them. So when you have all this in place, you have demand. You have demand for your product. You know, I know some farmers, Doug. I know some farmers. As they produce, they know who we buy. As they produce, they know who we buy. So they're doing every time is increasing people that will eat their products, and then they now go and produce for them. That is the peak of farming business. It is not all this production seminar, you know, you do more of the seminars they do in the industry is about production, all this production. Then they're not educating farmers how to sell the product. So the farmers is always, you have so many farmers who know so much about, they even know more than vet doctors.
Exactly.
They know more than animal scientists. Yet they are not making money in farming because they don't know how to sell the product.
And Dr. Deji Folutile, an amazing moment. Well, if you're watching and you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, I'm marketing now. This is the best time to do that. I was spending a lot of time telling you to subscribe to the YouTube channel, like the video, and then after this live session, you also have the opportunity to share the video, because a lot of farmers need to hear this. I've been in the industry for 14, 15 years now. I've seen farmers struggle. I know that the people who are not struggle has an edge. And trust me, this 45 minutes masterclass might just be the edge you need. Have you ever thought about it, Dr. You know, you said a couple of things. I'm going to highlight them now, and then I'll ask you the next question. An average egg is being sold for 50 to 80 naira, depending, 17 naira on the average. A bottle of beer is being sold for around 200 to 700 naira, depending, maybe even more. I don't know what that is. Have you ever imagined, you know, Dr. Digifolutile said, it's a buyer's market. And if it's a buyer's market, you are almost always at a loss. Can you ever imagine that the one egg you're producing now can be sold at 400 naira? Because people know this. No, you know, people will quickly want to say that they won't buy. But they are buying beer. Like, they are buying beer.
Yeah.
If you put a bottle of beer and one piece of egg, cooked egg, which is more nutritious? The egg, right?
Yeah.
So people are bypassing what is nutritive to their body or what will help them to something that will harm them because somebody understands what Dr. Deji Folutile is saying. Yeah. Marketing.
Marketing. Marketing.
You know, he has said that we are product-oriented, production-oriented, not marketing-oriented. Dr. Deji, you've gotten a convert, right? I want to change. What is the first step I need to take to become marketing-oriented? Go ahead.
So when you start from marketing, I always tell people, I said, life is about decisions. You have to make decisions. And I call it marketing decision. And so a farmer must understand that, number one, my business is first of all marketing before farming. In fact, my business is marketing. Of what use going to the farm to produce, going through all those labels, and then I produce, I cannot sell, or I sell, I'm selling at small margin, or I'm selling at a loss. I mean, it wasn't worth it. The first rule of every business is to make profit. And the only way you can make profit is if you have the buyers, the users in your pocket. If you have as many users as possible for product, you can begin to work on prices with them. So farmers need to change their orientation. That, okay, even though I'm doing farming business, the business is marketing. My business is marketing. So it means that my business is collecting customers for my products. My business is collecting customers for my products. So it means, okay, my business is data business. Data business. I need to have customer data. I need to build customer data. I need to work on my customers' data. I need to constantly educate my workers on customer service, excellence. Now, people come to buy my product. The experience they have in the process means they want to come back again and again and again. I need to look at the things that will enhance my product being acceptable, like quality, and work on it. I need to be in the platforms where end users are. I need to build friends online, offline, because everybody must eat. Food is, you know, how to eat food. I need to enlighten them to know that I'm a farmer, I'm producing food. So your focus on that area is more important than your focus on production. Now, you know why, doctor? Now, if I so much develop myself in these areas of the business, and assuming I'm a farmer, but I develop myself so much in this area of customer, customer experience, customer service, data, platforms, I keep knowing more and more people. I keep getting people who can use my product. Now, maybe in production, I'm just about 50%. And you are 90% on production. But you don't know all these things I know. Then I'm selling my product. Then you come, I mean, doctor, please, I have some chicken I cannot sell. I say, bring them. But doctor, this is my price, I'm going to buy you. So I don't know much like you on production. You are a guru in production. But I'm buying more cars. I'm traveling abroad every year. At the end of the day, business is about marketing. You know, the same thing I tell my colleagues, my veterinary colleagues, you know, that even as a vet surgeon or as a vet surgeon, best surgeon my foot if you don't have marketing. Best surgeon my foot if you don't have marketing. As a medical doctor my foot if you are not a marketing medical doctor. So it goes beyond, I may not even know how to be a medical doctor, how to do the proper operation. I may be very deficient, but I know how to bring patients to the hospital. I know how to project the business, mm. and we employ you as the guru. Stay there, I'll be paying salary.
All right, so I see a lot of comments on the chat box. Maybe I should attempt to bring up the comments, but please, one of the things you need to do before, okay, let me try and bring up, okay. So, fantastic. Dr. Gani is saying he agrees with you, but will you recommend that Pan engages a marketing outfit professionally? So, we are going to talk about that shortly, what the industry needs to do to at least step up our activities on this. I see Ata Samson Abese say, bring them happening. Okay, all right. So, good job, Dr. DG. Marketing is the bane of the livestock industry. I'm happy you are changing operations orientation. I think those are all brilliant words. Let's have more of this comment. I'm going to get to Dr. Gani's question shortly. But before then, I have a couple of things. Oh, Dr. DG, the internet company are not doing. Okay, I think Dr. DG is going to come up shortly. Probably has a little challenge with his network. But look at what he's saying. And what he's saying is fundamental. Really very fundamental. He said, if you are in any business, in any operations, right? You need to focus 60% of your time in marketing the product, right? Then 30% of that time in ensuring that your production go well. And then 10% of that time in managing 60M, 30M, 10M. Dr. DG, you're back, right? All right, I'm going to be bringing him back up. All right. Oh. We wanted to cut short. We, you know, in some part of Nigeria, they said the internet or the network subscription was off. You're in Lagos, right? Where are you currently?
I'm in Lagos.
You're in Lagos. So that's before all those service providers goes off in Lagos, then it's off for the entire Nigeria. Yeah. So we welcome you back. All right. So okay. Dr. Gani is trying to bring up on the chat bot, right? This program is also geared, first of all, of course, at helping the average farmer. Now the average farmer understands how he needs to apportion his time. But you know, this thing we are saying, just very simply, is like turning yourself upside down, because you know people for years have been production oriented. Telling them now that they need to reduce that orientation and become marketing focused, because you know, come to think of it again, with the price of egg, it's still relatively very cheap compared to what the eggs can do in people's system, right?
Yeah.
So the second part of this whole meeting is to see how we can bring up ideas that can shape the industry right from this meeting, right? So what will you advise? What should you advise people like Pan? What should they do? What will you advise them to do? Because I see what you say, that they organize meetings around production. Sometimes they organize intense program around even the inputs they use, and very little time trying to upgrade the quality of the market so that we can conveniently raise the bar of the unit price of those products, and the farmers can smile to the bank, not struggle to the bank. Some farmers even hate the sound of the word bank, because they know that their balance is zero. What do you think, Pan? The Poultry Association of Nigeria or the Livestock Association in Nigeria and of course in Africa can do to help shape this all important discussion that we're having today?
Doug, I think it's very simple. Let's look at it on four levels. You see, first of all, I said something at the beginning of this discourse. I said, marketing is about making something attractive to the ultimate customer. So it could be a product, it could be a business, it could be, you know, an industry. So now we are looking at, in terms of farming now, we are looking at a business, we are looking at a product, we are looking at an industry. So how do we make this product attractive so much that an average end user feel that, look, I need to eat egg in a day. I need to eat chicken. I need to eat fish. How do we make that? How is creating awareness? And that is what is called marketing. You know, going gorilla marketing. I mean, I'm yet to see people. Okay. Now let's say on monthly basis, there must be maybe a kind of a jamboree around environment, talking about egg. You know, egg on television, egg on billboards, egg every month. People moving around the old communities. You know, they doing all these activities, budgeting money to make the product attractive to the ultimate consumer. That is as an industry now. But then, as a farmer who has a farm, let's say I have a farm in Otta. One day I was going to a place to see a client around one part of Lagos. I got to the street where he told me I should come. I was asking people there, please, I'm looking for this farmer here. He said, farmer? We don't have farmer in this area.
Can you imagine?
I said it's a very big poultry farmer. I said, a farmer, poultry farmer. They said they don't know.
Can you imagine that?
So you see, I mean, if you are a farmer and people on your street don't know you are a farmer, people don't see that, eat an egg a day on farming. People don't see you wearing a vest, going to even your mosque or your church, say, eat an egg a day. You know, it's good for your health. People don't see you making campaign for your product. How do you want the product to be enhanced? Now, they see people talking about their product every day, like Coca-Cola, like beer. Look at the way they glamorize beer. Beer. If you see the people of beer, say the majesty. It's KBAC, you know, the ultimate.
The way they glorify beer.
You know? And then, if you are doing this for egg, you know it's beneficial to people. So when you're talking about marketing, I think apart from being an industry, individual farmer has a work to do. That you need to go out there on social media and talk about egg. You need to go out there in your neighborhood and talk about egg, and talk about chicken, and talk about product, and talk about any farm product talking about. You need to also make it attractive to the end users. Now, Doc, here is the catch. When you have a product that is very attractive to end users, that people, you know, life is about marketing.
Exactly.
You know, something that is not something you can make so many things out of it. You can make a lot of money out of a molehill. That's marketing. You know, you see, you can, this product is what it does. And you are consistently bombarding people with it. It goes into their system. They even decide to do things without even knowing it, because they are now being subconsciously controlled. Now, farmers need to put resources into that area. They need to put resources into creating awareness for their farm products. It has to be done on individual level. It has to be done on body level, like PAN. It has to be done as industry. That will be done as a government. You know, so those things are very fundamental. Now, but you know some farmers who have taken that bull by the horns on themselves. Okay, if they're not going to produce, I'm going to do marketing for myself. What they have done is this, Doc. Now, I'm going to be focusing on marketing day and night. 60% of my time, I'm going to be focusing on where is this product going to. How am I going to eliminate middlemen? So they take this product directly to the end users. They go to villages. They go to the shops. They go to places. And when you buy from them, they make sure they have your number. They make sure you have your telephone number. They make sure you have your birthday. They make sure they have all those things so that they can continually talk to you. Madam, you have not bought egg this week. We have fresh egg. You know, all those things, you have to take effort in doing those things. Farmers should stop taking the job of vet doctors and animal scientists. Knowing so much about production, and at the end of the day, the energy has been spent on production, and they don't have energy anymore for marketing. So the middleman will come and say, well, if you don't sell at this price, sorry, I won't buy. By that time, the farmer is tired. He has put so much effort to produce, and little energy is left to sell the product. So the middleman will just sell the product cheaply. You see the catfish farmer who say it's not profitable because the middleman just come to price it anyhow. You see the poultry farmer, he said, what I'm making from egg is so small because the egg buyers, they come together as they form a clique. You know, they say, if you don't sell at this price, won't come and buy. But if you know, but me and you know that the egg buyers, they're not the one eating the egg now. People that are eating the egg is me and you, is the children at home, is people at home. So if you know so much of these people and you do a direct distribution to those people, you know, you cut off the middleman.
Okay, go ahead. Let me allow you
to the energy being spent on production. Look, let me tell you something. One of the prime ministers of Israel made one statement. You know, Israel is very good in agriculture, turning a desert to great farmland. In fact, they are most of the best producers of catfish in the world, even though they don't eat catfish. Now, Israel prime minister said something. He said, farming success is 95% science and 5% work. Did you get that? He said, farming success is 95% science and 5% work. But in Nigeria, it's other way around. You make it 95% work.
Or even 100%.
And 5% science. Now, if you do it the way it should be done, you know, where you are needed at any point in your business, including you, Dr. Doc, where you are needed in your business, 24/7 is the marketing area. Because it's the marketing area that turns your effort to money.
Fantastic.
It's the marketing area that turns your effort to money. So if I know where my products are going to end up, if I know so much of those people and I have them in my pocket, I can use anybody to produce for me and sell to them.
So
that is what farmers should understand.
Dr. Deji Folutile.
Yes.
If we pay you $1 million for this lesson, I think it will not be enough. But let's keep the money first. let's keep the money first. You know, it's just that we are running out of time. We might need to bring you back because there are quite a handful of discussion around this market. As I said, my experience in the industry, we have people who are kicked. And for them to absorb this knowledge, it will first of all shock them. You know how you spend a lot of your time wasting time. But what I tell them at the end of the day, check, is it working for you? Because sometimes a farmer argues, and then you bring in a new form of knowledge and he has like 10 reasons why it will not work. You don't need 10 reasons for it not to work. You only need one, right? If it's not working for you.
Doc, let me say something.
Go ahead.
Now, let's say I'm a poultry farmer. What will I do? Now, I will look for horses to ride. Now, my horses will be, I need a good veterinarian. I need a good veterinarian. I will ask around who knows about poultry work very well. You know, I need a good veterinarian. I need a good nutritionist. I will try and find a way to know as many people expert as possible and befriend them. You know, and made them my partners in business. You know, that is when it comes to all this production wahala, all the health problems, this vet is there for me. When it comes to production, animal scientist, this man is there for me. You know, I also partner with them and pay them what they are due. Then I will focus my attention on marketing. Where are my products going to end up to? Now I will develop an area whereby if you come and buy my product, 1 year is a customer for life. Once I meet you, you buy my egg, you keep buying my egg. Because number one, I will make sure I get your data. I make sure I prevent you. Then I will make sure I present myself in communities. If I'm farming in a community, I will know the king of that community. I will know the principal of the schools. I will be giving them samples of egg every month. As don't give away. Oh, I'm the one feeding the barley of this village. I'm giving egg, one crate of egg. If I can influence the barley of the village, I can influence the subjects. If I can influence the principal of a school, I can influence the students. So I look for communities. I know those opinion leaders. Which I'm partnering with. I'm giving them eggs, maybe I'm giving them as a gift basis, or I'm giving them as reduced cost, because I know they have a lot of influence. And through their influence, I'm getting people to come and buy my eggs. And I'm building data. I'm building data. My major business will be on marketing. I will leave the work of animal health on the vet doctors, the work of production on the animal scientists, and I will compensate them as I'm getting money from the product. I'm also giving them money.
Exactly. It's just that our time, you see, 45 minutes. Before you go, 45 minutes gone. Wow, so short a time. So short a time. But you are throwing in some dynamite that I think every farmer needs to listen to. If you've not subscribed to this YouTube channel, I think it's a good time to do that. You need to like this video. Once we are done with this live session, the video will be live on our channel. You could share it on Farmers Group. Farmers need to hear this, because this can literally change a struggling farmer to a farmer that will be a star. I want to take a few comments. So we have quite a handful of people. I know somebody. Mbayiwa, where are you calling from? Are you in Nigeria? Because we have some people. Dr. Cha says the livestock farm should look for indirect demand through value addition and packaging. I believe that value addition, packaging, we are all talking about. Marketing.
It's all marketing. See,
see, beer. You know, you talked about beer. See, billboard. They paint, they attach a beer to a status symbol. Like, if you're not taking this beer, you are probably missing out. Missing out from your friends, missing out from the status symbol. You know, you also said you could make a mountain out of a molehill.
Yeah.
People pay for perception, right?
Yeah, that's it. Perception is money.
Fantastic.
Perception is money. So the farmers need to understand that. They need to understand and build their business. Look, I tell you, I said, it's about decision. Once a farmer decide and said, even though I'm doing farming, my real business is marketing. Once a farmer can come out with that, look at it now. If you look at a farmer who is doing anything on marketing, anytime he has problem, the first thing he cut off is the marketing expenses.
Yeah, that's it.
Because of ignorance.
That's it.
Why am I wasting money to do all this? And I beg, okay, you want to buy data, we want to be in Facebook. I beg, we don't have money now. And he will put all his effort on producing. After producing, he cannot sell the product. You hear about it? Okay, now.
Or he sells the product below cost price.
I always say something. I say, when you talk about egg blood, to say there is egg blood and a farmer is burying eggs is a shame. Instead of burying your eggs, can't you use that egg as marketing? Can you use that egg to it's a loss now. Let me use this product, let me package it and begin to deliver to hospitals, to the palaces, to the schools, free of charge or reduce rates, and create awareness, create a demand, for the product. Can't I use the product at this time? Okay, I'm making notes now, no problem. Let me give it out to the opinion leaders who can influence subjects to buy eggs for me tomorrow. So at the end of the day, it's all about marketing. Talking about packaging, value addition, it's all marketing. Making your product so attractive so that even you make selling unnecessary. Okay, assuming somebody comes to your place, come and buy egg, doctor. And then maybe he has come to the farmhouse. Maybe he comes to the farmhouse and then he comes to buy egg. Maybe he's buying about 200 crates. As he park his car to buy eggs, you have told your people, your workers, they should go to the man, go and wash his car. They wash his car, do everything. The car is looking neat. The man finished buying egg. He comes to the car. The car has been washed. While he was buying the egg, you know, there's a music going on, playing some old-time music. If you are wasting his time, you give him a Coca-Cola, or you give him a something, or you give him a boiled egg to attend. So you create customer experience for that man. He wants to come again and again and again and again to come and buy from you. So it's all marketing. It's just that we don't have time. It's all marketing. Everything is the level of what you are getting from any business is the level of marketing you are putting into it.
I think this video should be shared widely. After this live meeting, pick it up. I'll share it on YouTube, and you need to put it on Farmers Group, because farmers need to understand. You don't need to argue with the superior knowledge, right? If you are a farmer and you check your bank account and it doesn't make you happy, it's time to change what you know. Because you know, you can't continue doing the same thing the same way and expecting what? A different result. They said that is one of the height of insanity, right?
Insanity, yes.
Don't argue. Just go to your, if you don't know your bank balance, call your bank, call your account officer. Tell them, what's my bank balance? If it doesn't look like what you want, it's time to stop the argument and face reality. Dr. Deji, you will give us a final word.
I'm going to give a final word as a quote. A quote from, I think it's from Peter Drucker. I don't know. Yeah, I think it's from Peter Drucker. There's a quote I have from that talker that business is about marketing. You know, that is that business is about the customer. And if you are talking about the customer, you are talking about marketing. So what I would like farmer to take away from this discourse is that, look, go back to 60-30-10.
Somebody was saying 60, you should explain 30. It, but I was going to tell the person to go back, rewatch the video, because I know you made a good point around that. Go ahead.
Yeah. Look, let me tell you something. They said information is knowledge is power. Now, knowledge is no longer as powerful as attention. Attention is power. Attention is the most powerful thing in the world. Anything you give your attention to, that is what controls your life. Now, if you give your attention to marketing, 60% of your time in your farming business, and then 30% of your time to production, and 10% to management, you are going to be smiling to the bank in the next 1 year. I guarantee it. Because when you know the end users, when you know the end users, the money you are looking for is in the pocket of the end users. So when you know the end users and you can attract the end users, you are in business. You don't even know, you don't even need to know how to be to do production. And I challenge a farmer, I challenge you today. I say a lot of people are making money in farming business who don't even know how to produce anything. Because they know marketing. So marketing is king any day, anytime.
Dr. Deji Folutile, you know, it's been an amazing, we just have to end because we have a time allotted to this whole program. But listen, farmers, dear farmers, what you want is not chicken, it's not egg. What you want is money, right?
It's money.
So you can't focus on the process and lose sight of the end.
I like that.
If people are not appreciating what you're doing, it's time to invest in what can make them appreciate it the more. And the background of everything we have discussed for the last 54 minutes is that you need to prioritize marketing. I'd like you to like this video, share it, put it on Farmers platform, tell them to subscribe, because we will sure bring up Dr. Deji Folutile again for Marketing 102. This is Marketing 101. We will bring him back up again to tell us exactly, step by step. Now we know we all need to focus on marketing. We will now start discussing how do we do it. How do we pack it? Even from your dressing, you see some farmers dress, you will never want to be a farmer.
Yes.
Some farmers are even richer than some bankers. But who will you trust more with your money? The person whose perception is looking like he will never run with your money. Some farmers. So let me not preempt Marketing 102. I want to thank you, Dr. Deji Folu, today for this awesome, amazing time. I assure you, we will pick the video, we will share it on all our platforms, we will share it to all farmers, because this very thought that you have thrown out could be the most life-saving thought that have the single capacity to transform the industry for the better. Once we start buying egg at 400, 500, not because the economy is getting bad, but people all of a sudden understand the value of one egg.
Value, to human life.
That they can pay whatever it is they pay to drink a beer to buy an egg. Then your idea must have transformed an entire industry. Dr. Deji Folu, today, thank you so very much. My team and I are very grateful that you have come on this master class to educate farmers, to tell us what it takes to market and to be on top of our industry. We will sure bring you back again. To all viewers, all right, please share the video, like the video, ensure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we have multiple masterclass coming up. From me and my team and Dr. Deji Folu today, we say goodbye and have a wonderful afternoon. Thank you. Cheers.